गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम फॉर टुडे सेशन. आई एम हेयर फॉर मैथमेटिक्स ऑफ क्लास 10. इन प्रीवियस सेशन स्टूडेंट, वी डिड सम क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एग्जांपल्स एंड टुडे विल स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज 6.2. सो लेट्स डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. इन फिगर 1 एंड 2, DE इज पैरेलल टू BC. फाइंड EC इन फिगर 1 एंड AD इन फिगर 2. ओके स्टूडेंट, फिगर 2 इज दिस एंड फिगर 1. सो स्टूडेंट, बिफोर स्टार्ट टू सॉल्व, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू चेक दैट व्हाट थिंग्स इज गिवन एंड विच हेल्प्स इन सॉल्यूशन. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट इन क्वेश्चन नंबर इन पार्ट 1. इट इज गिवन दैट DE इज पैरेलल टू BC. ओके, so you know that theorem 6.1, if the line is parallel to the one side of the triangle, so it divides the rest two sides in two equal ratio. So by using this theorem, so AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. Now this term we able to find the value of EC. okay, so just replace the value of AD. AD is 1.5 and DB is 3 centimeter. okay, AE is 1 centimeter and EC we have to find. Just replace the value, 1.5 upon 3 equal to 1 upon EC. So students, by cross multiplication, EC here and 3m, C into 1.5, 3 into 1. Now EC equal to 3 upon 1.5, so after dividing we obtain 2 centimeter. So students, here we obtain the value of EC is 2 centimeter. So now students, second part you have to do by yourself. Okay, it is as a homework to you. Now number 2, E and F are points on the sides PQ and PR respectively of a triangle PQR. For each of the following cases, state whether EF is parallel to QR. So students, in this triangle we have PQR is a triangle and E and F are two points. Okay, so students, values are given here. Okay, each part PE, EQ, PF and FR. If the ratio, we have to check if the ratio is equal, then we able to say that EF is parallel to QR. So students, very easy. So let's solve. PQR is a triangle. For to be parallel of EF QR, the ratio should be equal. The ratio of the sides should be equal. Okay, so by using theorem 6, converse of the theorem 6.1 and 2 both. Okay, so students, now check the ratio. PE upon EQ, PF upon FR. Okay, just replace the value. PE is given here 3.9 and EQ is 3 and PF 3.6 and FR is 2.4. After solving, just check whether left hand side is equal to right hand side. No. So hence strength, the ratio is not equal. If the ratio is not equal, that means the line EF is not parallel to QR. Similar way is to the question. Now second part of question number 2. P is 4 cm and QE equal to 4.5 cm. PF equal to 8 and RF equal to 9 cm. Okay student, so same triangle we have PQR and EF. We have to check EF is parallel to QR. How will check? Because the ratio of the side is given. If the ratio is equal, that means it is EF is parallel to QR, otherwise not. So if the ratio of the sides are equal, means EF is parallel to QR. So let's see, ratio of the sides is PE upon EQ equal to PF upon FR. So let's replace the values, 4 upon 4.5 and 8 upon 9. Now we'll check 4 upon 4.5 equal to 4 upon 4.5, means left hand side equal to right hand side. Hence the ratio is equal. The ratio is equal, so means EF is parallel to QR. Okay students, in third part of this question number 2 you have to do. Let's see student, question number 3. In figure, if LM is parallel to CB, okay, and LM is parallel to CD, so prove that AM upon AB is equal to AN upon AD. Okay students, whenever we have to prove here any proof type questions, first we have to do given things. First we have to separate out what the given thing, then what we have to prove, and then how to prove. Okay students, so let's see what are the given things here. So in triangle, given at LM is parallel to BC and in triangle ADC LN is parallel to CD. As you know that it is directly related to the theorem 6.1. okay, so now what we have to prove here, AM upon AB, AN upon AD. okay, so AM upon AB, AM upon AB and AN upon AD, we have to prove. So students, let's start in triangle ABC. okay, another triangle is ADC. okay, so in triangle ABC we know that ML is parallel to BC, so by using theorem 6.1 we can write the ratio of AM upon MB is equal to AL upon LC. okay, denoted as equation 1. okay students, so in another triangle ADC, same LN is parallel to DC, so we can write the ratio of the sides AN upon ND and AL upon LC as denoted as equation 2. So by in the equation 1 and 2, observe that AL upon LC is common both sides. Okay, means is equal. If the this AL upon LC is here again AL upon LC, so students, we can write it as these two rest part is also equal. From equation 1 and 2 we obtain AM upon MB is equal to AN upon ND because these two terms are equal. So if the equal are with the any other terms, so means that those terms also are equal. So students, now we'll check, we have to prove AM upon AB, but here is MB. okay, so now AM and MB, the sum of the both is we obtaining here AB. Similar way student, what we'll do, just do the reciprocal of it. So the reciprocal of it is MB upon AM and ND upon AN. Now add one both side. Okay, so MB upon AM plus 1 and ND upon AN plus 1. Now take the LCM of it. So here is, assume one denominator. So AM into 1 means AM. So AM here, then MB will same, then 1 into AM means AM. Similarly way student, AN plus ND upon AN. Okay, you know that the sum of MB and AN is equal to AB and sum of AN and ND is equal to AD. okay, so AB upon AM is equal to AD upon AN. Now again we have to prove that AM upon AB, but here is AB upon AM, so now again reciprocal of it, we obtain AM upon AB is equal to AN upon AD, hence proved students. Let's do question number 4. In figure DE is parallel to AC and DF is parallel to AE, prove that BF upon FE is equal to BE upon EC. okay students, so in the same type of question, first we have to write that what thing is given and then what to prove, and proof means solution. Okay, so students, given here DE is parallel to AC, DE is parallel to AC. okay, second is DF is parallel to AE. okay, now what we have to prove here, BF upon FE is equal to BE upon EC. okay, now prove. So first we'll take the triangle ABE. okay, ABE, so it is given that students, DF is parallel to AE. okay, the side is parallel to the one side of the triangle, so the line divides the two other sides in ratio, so by using same theorem 6.1. okay, so BD upon DA is equal to BF upon FE, marked as equation 1. Similar way students, will do the whole triangle ABC. okay, as it is given that in triangle ABC DE is parallel to AC, so again by using theorem 6.1, if a line is parallel to one side of the triangle, that means the ratio is equal of two other sides. So here BD upon DA, okay, and BE upon EC, yes, mark it as equation 2. Now students, by using equation 1 and 2, you can check that one term is common. So the term is BD upon DA is common in both equations. So if it is equal, So rest two terms are also equal. So we can write it as equation one is as BD upon DA is equal to BF upon FE and BD upon DA and equal to B upon EC. So now this term is equal, both terms are equal. So it means rest term also equal to each other. Okay. So we can write it as BF upon FC is equal to BE upon EC. Same we have to prove here. Okay, BF upon FC is equal to BE upon EC. Both are same. So student, hence proved.